Yes, brother.
Good evening, sir. My name is Ashish and my question is, there is concept in Islam by paying money to the victim's family. By paying money to victim's family from accused family and getting released from the crime, what is the concept behind that and is it not injustice with the victim's family?
The brother asked the question that what is the concept of diya money, means paying blood money in Islam, that if someone has murdered someone or killed someone, whatever reason, the family members of the person who's murdered can excuse by taking diya money. This concept is that if someone is driving a car or maybe by mistake while walking something happens or by accident someone dies, here if it is out of negligence, yet for example a doctor is doing surgery and it is proven out of negligence the patient has died, Islamic law, death penalty. But there the relatives of the person who has died, fine, we agree the niyyah was good, he didn't actually kill my son, I forgive him. But negligence, if it is done while trying to save a life, he goes scot-free. But if negligence, he does something and the person dies, then death penalty, because his fault. In this case, if it's proven it is 100% negligence, then the family members may say, oh, even if it's negligence, I forgive him. Okay, I forgive him, like free. I forgive him by taking 1 rupee or by the 1 million rupees. Maybe that 1 million rupee may be a penalty. Okay, don't do it again. Now you have done it. I don't want to take your life. I forgive you. 1 million rupees is a penalty. So this concept in Islam that the person who has died, his family members can forgive by asking a penalty. If it is a conspiracy and a murder, 100% proven, then it is death penalty. These cases are mainly when we know that the person has a chance to be forgiven. If someone goes and does a bomb blast on the street and kills 100 people, innocent people, no forgiving, death penalty direct. You understand? Now, for example, while if you're doing something, maybe a building is being constructed, fine, and there's negligence, the worker gets electrocuted. It's the fault of the builder. Now the family members say, okay, I don't mind forgiving. You know, my husband used to give me every day 2,000 rupees. Now, if I demand 500,000 rupees, even his full life, how much could he give me? 25,000 a year? 5 lakh would take how many years? How many? 20 years. So now if I take that 5 lakh rupees, I can invest it somewhere and get 4,000 rupees, 5,000 rupees a month. Correct? So fine, I forgive him. And with this money, at least I can survive. The various aspects and angles, this is not the only aspect. I'm giving you examples. So in this way, what happens? At least in Indian law, finish, death penalty. But oh, bichare ka bread enough to mar gaya na, usko fayda kya hua? Does the government take care of him? The earning member has died. The wife and children are on the street. Does the government help? No. So here at least as a compensation, now they invest the money, every month they get 5,000 rupees. So at least some part of their life is taken care of. It may not compensate completely. And sometimes the person may just forgive without taking money also. So therefore, there are various situations Islam has permitted so that it's beneficial for both. Hope that answers the question.